have a letter to read here from Sister Pat Vanderburg. And there's a message from Sister Pat Vanderburg. I'm a sister of St. Joseph, a native of Green Bay, who spent 25 years living in Peru. I'm now retired. I continue to do volunteer work among the Hispanic community in my parish and in Green Bay Diocese. I will celebrate my 60th anniversary as a sister in 2021. I regret that I will not be able to speak to your parish community and meeting you personally. I was looking forward to it. Know that you hold a place in my prayers as together we continue to support one another during this challenging time. The Sisters of St. Joseph of Carolandette have been in Peru since 1962. They are called to serve the poor, even before the pandemic, comprised 73% of the population working in the internal workforce. This means working in whatever job they can find or selling whatever they can on the streets in order to feed their families. Our sisters are involved in parish work, education, and prison ministry. During this time of pandemic, when their usual ministries are limited, donations enable them to bring food baskets to the neediest families and collaborate in a common soup kettle being prepared in the streets. The needs of the poor are overwhelming. Our sisters walk the barrios and look for the white flag to signal where help is needed. In addition to food, they share with the people a word of encouragement, a shared prayer, or their supportive presence in a neighborhood funeral, which must take place in the street since churches are closed. If you are willing to help and able to help, you can do so in three different ways. Pray for them and the others who are facing overwhelming challenges worldwide due to economic and social injustices. Do your part by being faithful to your baptismal call to work for a more just world. If possible, contribute to the sisters working on the poor by giving to the mission appeal in your parish today. Or you can find us on your webpage at Castro. I'm going to spell this. CAJDAARONDELET.org. Anybody who needs it after church, come and get this, please. Thank you for partnering with the Sisters of St. Joseph's and our mission ministries and for responding generously to our Bishop Rickon's call to be missionaries and disciples.
Please stand at this time for our opening song, Holy God, we praise thy name.
Thank you. morning. It's a beautiful day. It's going to be a little humid this afternoon. Hope it's rain. I don't know whether it's rain or summer. As we gather here this morning, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Our dear friends, today we remember the 21st Sunday in ordinary time. The liturgy invites us to think about what is my personal connection with Jesus. In other words, Jesus asked this question to all of us, who do you say that I am? So today let us ask to make that connection happen. For that, let us pray the grace of God in this Mass. To celebrate this sacred mystery in a worthy manner, let us acknowledge our weaknesses and ask God's mercy. I confess, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Mother of God, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Oh God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. The first reading is a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to Shebna, master of the palace, I will thrust you from your office and pull you down from your station. On that day, I will summon my servant Eliakim, son of Hilkiah, and will clothe him with your robe and gird him with your sash, and give over to him your authority. He shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. I will place the key of the house of David in Eliakim's shoulder. When he opens, no one shall shut. When he shuts, no one shall open. I will fix him like a peg in a secure spot to be a place of honor for his family. The word of the Lord. Second reading is a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Oh, the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God. How inscrutable are his judgments, and how unsearchable his ways. For who has known the man of the Lord, and who has been his counselor? Or who has been given the Lord anything that he may be repaid? For from him and through him and for him, all things.
Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, and he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Then he strictly ordered his disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. The Gospel of the Lord.
Dear friends, three men were traveling on a ship when they are accosted by the devil. The devil proposes that if each man drops something into the sea and he cannot find it, he will be that man's slave. If the devil does find it, however, he will eat that man up. The first man drops a pure, clear diamond and immediately gets eaten. The second drops an expensive watch trying to impress the devil and gets eaten. The third man fills a bottle up with water and pours it into the sea, yelling, "You think I am a fool? Try finding that." It's a little joke, okay? It's a trick joke, maybe. Dear friends, during today's times, we become so familiar with online shopping, are doing most of the things online, right? Now, everything's virtual. We're trying to do more things, maybe the schools and our CCD. Things are going to go online than in-person classes. There is a survey in all shopping or anything you do. They want to know your experience with them in getting what you wanted. It is done in all the fields, wherever you go now. They ask you to take a survey right after, even if you go to the hospital, they ask you to take a survey. How was the doctor's visit? How did the nurse treat you? And what is your experience, good or bad? Or scale 1 to 10, like that. You have everything online, there is a survey. Today's reading, especially the Gospel, also asks you to take a survey about your experience with God in your life. Or Jesus wants to know how people have evaluated him in their life, or how people did understand him, or what do they say about him. These are the questions Jesus wants to know from you today, you and me. Everyone, those who are here, those who are watching online, will have different answers. And I don't expect the same answers from everyone. Jesus is the Son of God for all of us. But why I say we don't need to have the same answers for everyone is depends how you relate with him. That's why Jesus asked this question to the disciples. He has been doing miracles. He has been preaching about different things to them. And they have been living with him, maybe about 3 years. very closely, very intimately. Now Jesus wants to know what people say, because he sent them two and two into different places. They also go somewhere and visit. And like when you visit some places, people ask. Like when I want to go to South Dakota, I ask, hey, what to see there? And they said, Father, don't miss Mount Rushmore and Gracie Horses, right? Those are the places to be visited. So I drove like all the way there. It's a long, boring drive because everything else is very dry. But you see a beautiful monument there. So that's why people want to know different opinions. And Jesus asked the disciples, hey, what do the people say about me? And those disciples, what they heard from people, they brought. Okay, some say about Jeremiah, some say Elijah, some say John the Baptist. If you listen to those three people, they were looked like a representative of God in their own time. Elijah, Jeremiah, and John the Baptist, they were like a forerunners of Jesus Christ from the Old Testament and the New Testament. Now Jesus has another personal question to them. What do you say that about me? How much do you understand me? It's a personal question. When you ask a personal question, sometimes we are stuck there. When you ask about general thing, we are ready to answer about it. But when you ask something personal, we have to think about, right? So Peter represents the group and say, you are the Son of God. And Father Albert Nolan, who is a great theologian, has written a book on Jesus before Christianity. He talks about the historic aspect of Jesus Christ as a human being. And the gospel writers, in all the gospel writers, they talk about the divinity of Jesus Christ. If you read all the gospel writers, they try to prove that Jesus is the Son of God by all the events. If you especially take John, from the beginning, he can compress John's gospel in three words: love, life, God. Jesus is life, Jesus is love, Jesus is God. This is the main core message he is trying to tell in all of his gospel. But what is your answer? I remember I have told you before this one, I always look at Jesus as my friend. Because if you read the Bible, in even John's gospel, we see Thomas said, Lord, you are my God. Nathaniel said, you are the Messiah. And Peter said, you are the Messiah. And we hear from different people, even the last week we had the Canaanite woman said, I believe that you are the Messiah, you can do this. So we have different experience of people in the Gospels telling that Jesus is the Messiah. For me, he's the Messiah, he's the Son of God. When I celebrate the Mass in the altar, I believe that he's God. And earlier, if you look at the scripture in the Old Testament, we call God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, God of our forefathers, God of Israel. But when Jesus introduced, he made a relationship with God the Father. He told to call God Abba. So that is the point where he made a relationship. He wanted us to make a relationship with God and identify, recognize him with some terms. Like when you say aunt and uncle and niece and nephews, you got some relationship. When you say some friends or the community people, it's all in general. But when you say, he's my aunt, he's my uncle, he's my nephew, he's my niece, you have more intimate relationship. If you don't have intimate relationship, you won't call somebody, so-and-so is my cousin, so-and-so is my nephew. So that's one of the reasons for me, I look at him as my friend, who can walk with me, who can be joyful when I am joyful, who can support me when I am struggling, who can cry with me when I cry. Sometimes we can see that. I have seen that When I cry, Jesus also cries like. That's my feeling. So today Jesus asks you to recognize like that. That's why he asked, who do you say that I am? Don't worry about what others say, but what you say. How do you make this relationship happen? How do you connect yourself to me? Jesus is asking all of us the same question. The church is a place where we go and celebrate his sacrifice, the Eucharist. We recognize him here. And how do you recognize him in your life? If we can recognize with some relationship, that's why Bishop Ricken has given those missionary discipleship to know him, to understand him, to worship him and share him with others. If I don't know him, if I don't relate with him some closer term, I cannot be closer. If I call somebody mom or dad, that makes me more comfortable, more related, more intimate to them. That relationship brings more things. So today, how do you want to relate with Jesus? What are the terms that you are going to use? It doesn't need to be the same thing. I like friendship because he says in the Gospel of John chapter 15, I call you friends. You are not slave anymore. I call you friends. That's why I chose that name. Okay, he's going to be my friend. That's how I have been following in my priesthood. And you can relate with him in so many terms. He doesn't worry about the term, what term you want to, but try to connect. That's why he poses that question to the disciples and to all of us, who do you say that I am? If I made a relationship, if I make a commitment, I will know who I am. If I don't commit, if I don't make a relationship, I cannot understand who I am and who is he for me. So both are connected here. When we ask this question, when we find an answer for this question. So today, Jesus asks the same question to all of us. Who am I for you? Who are you for me?
Stand up and proclaim our faith. I believe in one God, confidence that Jesus is ever present in the Church of Peter, the Rock, let us now bring our needs to the God of all mercies.
For our church, there may be a living and true reflection of the light of Christ, a beacon of goodness to the world, and a welcoming refuge for the poor, the hungry, and those who seek to be comforted. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, successor of St. Peter as the Rock, may the Lord give him the strength and courage to continue his work for church
also pray for those that have gone for their college studies, all our parishioners, all our confirmation students who are already in the college. May God be with them and give them courage and strength to go through all the education this year. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
let us pray. Give us, Lord, your saving help as we make these prayers with the hope. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and fruit of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the wine and earth of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, you gain for yourself your people by adoption, through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
Yes.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Oh,
by sending down your spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and gave you thanks, and gave the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy, especially Gary Bendler, whom remember this Mass today. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, in all the saints, Saint Mary Magdalene, our patroness saint, for please be throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
together the sign of peace. Here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ to live and share the gospel. Dear friends, I have some reminders. The first one about the missionary appeal. The sister Pat was supposed to be here. Because of the COVID, she couldn't make it. So you heard the message. And it's good that we support the missionary priests and nuns that are working in the diocese, like me. There are several priests working in the diocese, and they do some mission activities in their own country. So it's always nice to support us as an extended family. Pray for the family in the world and support our financial support. So most of that, thank you so much. And if you're not done, there's a separate basket for that. Or if you want to take an envelope and bring it next week, that also can be done. So there are some envelopes at the narthex table. So feel free to take one and bring it next week if you'd like to support those activities around the world. Thank you. And the second thing about the blood donation drive, and we have one in September, Saturday, 12th of September, from 7:30 to noon. If you are able to donate blood, you are welcome to do, but you have to register. So there is some information about that. And also, take that brochure and give your friends, if you are going to some businesses, if you are acquainted with the people in the businesses, you can help them hang there so that people can see and donate blood on that day. And even like if you are going to the library, if you know somebody working in the library or in other places, in other churches, share with your friends. So feel free to take and share with your friends so that the message is reached out everywhere in the community where you can support the community through these activities. That's why we choose to do that. And the third one is, I think you all get the emails, weekly emails about the bulletin and the mass, song, other things. And we have recently sent out a letter to those people who don't have an email access. So if you didn't receive both, either call the office or please let me know. We want to reach out to all of the parishioners. So if you didn't get email, if you don't get emails weekly, please let us know. If you didn't get that letter, let us also know so that we can help you to communicate with you what we are doing here or reach out to you in a good manner. So please let us know. Thank you and God bless you. Have a nice weekend.
If anybody wants that email address for Sister Vandenberg after Mass, I'll have this letter on